the Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning, my dear friends in Christ. We begin this Sunday reflection in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today is another day that the Lord has made and we are glad in it. Thank you, Jesus. Our Bible reading today is from the Gospel of Luke chapter 20, from verse 27 to 38. And our topic is God of the living. God of the living. Hallelujah. Amen. In the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ, many people followed him looking for the truth. Some followed because of his miracles. But there were others who followed looking for excuses to justify their belief or trying to trap him. Some of the people want to put him in conflict with the government and religious authorities. In the passage of today, the Sadducees, who don't believe in the doctrine of the resurrection, wanted to bring the master in conflict with the law of Moses and the issue of life after death. Their question was that if a woman married more than one man, which of the men will be her husband in the life to come after death? If truly there is resurrection, who will be her husband? The answer of the Lord is that God is the God of the living. God is the God of the living. We serve a living God, and he is also the God of the living. Of course, there is life after death, but the journey to eternity starts from this world. Hear me again. The journey to eternity starts from this world. Only the living can serve God. What happens at the resurrection is in the hands of God. Only the living can serve God. But we must prepare for that life while we are alive in this world. Brothers and sisters, the Lord is telling you that is listening to me now, to listening to this message, that you should prepare for that life while you are living. Prepare, because only the living can serve God. Let me ask you this question, child of God. Are you living for God while you still have your life, your breath? While you are still alive, are you living for God? Are you alive in God? Is God alive in you? Do you recognize God as the God of the living? The only life that will count after death is the life that is lived for God. The only life that will count after death is that life that is living for God. I pray that you will understand this message. May God help us to live for him while we are alive, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May God give us understanding to live for God. Only the living can serve God. You can't serve God when you are dead. You are alive now. Are you serving God? Are you serving God now that you are alive? Remember, when you die, you can't serve God. God is giving you opportunity to retrace your ways. To retrace your ways. Come back to serve God, because only the living can serve God. May the Lord give us understanding in the name of Jesus. Amen. Happy Sunday, and have a fruitful week ahead. You are highly blessed. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.